Okay, so an observer on a cliff, 100, we're just gonna say miles, because I feel like we're comfortable with miles. 1,000 miles above sea level sights two ships due east. We're gonna say west. West, no, east, you're right. I'm going crazy. Okay, so there's two ships. So let's draw one of the ships here. Boom, and we will just put the other ship right next to it. The angles of depression of the ships are 47 degrees and 32 degrees. That means you're standing on the edge of the cliff. And your normal eyesight looking straight out looks like this. But to see the ships, you need to have an angle of depression. In other words, your sight line is going to go down. So to see one of the ships, it has to go down 47 degrees. And to see the other ship, again, here's your normal sight line. Your sight line has to go down 32 degrees. Okay, so obviously 32 degrees is smaller than 47 degrees. So, once again, the angle of depression, we're using our alternate interior angles. Keep in mind, if I'm to trace this pink one, you can see that right here, that alternate interior angle. So if this is 47 degrees, in order to make these lines parallel, this opening also has to be 47 degrees. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this pink 47 degrees angle from up here, and we are going to move it right down here because we learned about parallel lines. And we're gonna do the same thing with this blue 32 degree angle. We're gonna create this angle right here that is also 32 degrees. And it's asking me to find the distance between the ships. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm going to find the distance of this ship at the bottom in the pink triangle. And I'm gonna call this X. And then we're gonna take the bigger blue triangle, and I'm gonna call the distance of the bottom of this Y. Okay, so I'll draw little replicas of the pink and the blue triangle. So here's one of my triangles again. 1,047 degrees X. And then we have our blue triangle, and that ship is a little bit farther out. We're still 1,000 high, but this angle of depression was 32 degrees. So these are essentially our two triangles that we're going to be working with. So because we're dealing with the opposite and the adjacent sides for both of the triangles, opposite and adjacent, we can write these equations using tangent, TOA. So the tangent of 47 is equal to the opposite side over the adjacent side. And the tangent of 32 is equal to the opposite side over the adjacent side. Let me bust out my phone and make sure it's in degree mode. Believe it or not, I'm not doing trig on a regular basis. So I'm going into, let's see, I always check it by doing the tangent of 45, and if it gives me one, I'm in degree mode, so I'm good. So I'm going to take the tangent of 47, hit equals, and I'm getting 1.07 is equal to 1,000 over X. Let's take the tangent of 32, and I am getting 0.62. equals 1,000 over Y. And then it's up to you how you want to solve this. I hate doing this because I don't know how you guys like to do this, but I feel like the easiest way is to turn it into a proportion. So put both of those over 1 and go ahead and cross multiply. So 1,000 is equal to 1.07X divided by 1.07. And X is equal to 1,000 divided by 1.07. And I'm getting 934.58 approximately. And then do the same thing over here. So 1,000 is equal to 0.62Y divide by 0.62, divide by 0.62. Y is equal to 1,000 divided by 0.62. And I'm getting 1612.90. But it's asking for how far apart these ships are. So if the pink part is 934.58, and the blue part is 1612.90, to figure out the difference between them, you would just subtract. So you'd get about 680 something. So that's about how far apart the ships are.